Hello everyone and a happy Saturday morning to you. Today's build will be AMT's 125th scale 1978 Ford Courier Mini Pickup in the Firestone Super Stones line. You've seen this out in the full-size Ford. Now you have it in the 78 Ford Courier. You saw me build the Ford Courier in another review as a completely stock fleet-sided base model. This one is an Auto World exclusive. You can only get it through autoworldstore.com. I will link down in the description where you can snag one of these limited edition kits before they are out of stock. But it will allow you to replicate everything you see on the box art. You will be able to build the model with. So let's take a look at everything in the box. When you snag yours, we'll take a look at the styrene first. First up is that Ford Courier cab. Large molding there. Be very careful with those side lights. They're thin, they could snap. You'll be removing these pieces. I always say leave those in. I put it on my little Tamiya body clamp and it keeps me from splitting those fenders out. You'll attach the back of the cab and everything, so we'll show that on camera. It has an optional sunroof you can cut out to replicate the box art. So you see that there. You'll just use your knife and go over that and over that and over that and over that until it finally comes through the other side. We've got our interior bucket. Very basic. It's got the door panel details on there. Got a little bit of carpet texture and some very thin pedals inside. That's our interior. What else we got over here? We've got our step side bed. We've got the wheel wells, tailgate, and wheel backs on there. You can see where your fuel filler will go, the custom fuel filler. There is no way to build a stock step side. You will be building pretty much what you see on the box art that's in this box. It's not a two-in-one. In this part here, we've got the back of the cab. We've got bumpers, stock four-cylinder, which you can do a little custom work on if you choose. It's got parts in there for custom intake and whatnot. We've got a one-piece frame, which makes life much easier. That's molded there. Seems to be pretty straight. It was in the stock Courier that I built. On this one here, we've got our custom front end, lower air dam, custom fender flares. Those will be these parts right here going down, and then that air dam there with that funky looking vertical headlight grille. That's your option on there. I do not see any stock parts for the grille or the front end. We've got our hood with all the louvers in it like the box art. Firewall, differentials, springs, inner fenders are a separate piece. We've got our dash gauge cluster, hood hinges, drive shafts, steering column, bed sides, and bed floor. What else we got going on? We've got a complete exhaust system with heat shield and small CB radio. Antenna. Got our little firewall here with some nice detail on it. Got our dashboard. Pretty much a basic, like a Mazda dashboard. That's where our gauge cluster will glue into just so they can mold it cleaner. Then we've got the nice looking tonneau cover. It's got buttons around the outside. Got a little flash, but it's nothing major. It's all that stuff that breaks off. It's not a big deal. And it's got that nice stretched texture to it. Front suspension arms. Looks like the drive shaft carrier. Fuel tank. Got our bench seat. Radiator. Other small engine parts. Kingpins. Steering wheel. All the accoutrement. Let's switch sides to the other side of the desk. Over here we've got our windshield set and back glass. We've got our sunroof and we've got our back glass. We've got a nice set of decals to replicate the box art. You don't have to, you can get a red paint. It doesn't say exactly what red they're using, but that is a bright red. Unlike the box, I thought it was a pinkish one. I'm like, how am I going to match that color? It's actually a bright red. Nice windshield banners. two sets of gauges for the dash. We've got white letter Firestone inserts that match the black ones. We've got a huge white Firestone emblem for the tonneau cover. We've got hot rod magazine logos. We've got Ford logos for the tailgate in red and black. Super Sports logos, side markers, Courier emblems. So yeah, we got a nice set of options on that decal sheet there. We've got two steel axles, which is pretty common for these kits. We've got one set of chrome parts with the custom wheels from the box art, those wagon turbine style wheels. And then we've got our custom headlights there. We've got our stockish wheels, bumper package, antenna, valve cover, shifter. We've got what looks like mirrors, sleek side mirrors, tail lights, custom grille. So we got all kinds of custom parts on there. And then finally, of course, it wouldn't be the Super Stones kit if it didn't have these gorgeous pad printed Firestone Super Sports tires. Nice tread, black on the other side. If you don't want to do this with the flames, you just want to have a nice custom pickup truck, and then with the wheels, and then put the white letters on there, or you want black walls for your style, you do have that option. So that's everything that's in the box. When you get your Super Stones Firestone kit from AutoWorldStore.com, I'm going to start building mine right now. Welcome again. After that comfortable build session, and I say comfortable because everything on the kit goes together on camera, pretty easy to put together. We got our little fuel tank here, so we'll be able to work on that. We'll get some paint on that. We've got our belt pulley and fan system, our smog pump, our alternator, all on there. We've got our stock steering wheel, it just happens to be on there. We got our radiator and our bench seat. I've glued the gauges together. You saw me do that on camera, I think. I did that on camera. I'm going to use the custom wheel because it is the custom Ford Courier. So that's a cool looking little one. Make sure you put this on the left side for the turn signal because this one does have a manual transmission. We've got these parts here. We got our air cleaner, radiator lines. So we want to get those painted up. On this tree here, we've got our nose piece and our fender flares on the front end. So we want to get those painted. And then we'll have to tape off a line and two-tone paint the front end there, our two-tone body color. Got our wheel backs on their own tree ready to get painted. The exhaust, the heat shield, and the CB radio ready to get painted. Our hood, our radiator support, battery, reservoir tank, and our second drive shaft. Those are all set and ready to be painted up. We got that nice little four banger. I am doing a mostly stock four cylinder, except that I will use the chrome valve cover so that it looks kind of cool. But that's what we'll have there. That goes together very easily. Love the little starter back here to be accurate. Little oil filter, distributor on there. The intake on the four with the carburetor up there, and then our air cleaner will go across at an angle like that with our manifold coming down to meet up to our exhaust system. Nice little unit. Could be using a lot of other things, a lot of other mini trucks you could slap that in. Got our tonneau cover. You see how nice that will fit over the back. Sport trucks got to have a tonneau cover. Looks cooler unless you put a pool in the back. We got our bed sitting on the frame. That, when we built it on camera, went together very nicely. Make sure that the fuel door is on the left side, and then you'll be set with that to go. The tailgate will operate if you desire it to. It's going to have the tonneau cover on mine and be a sport truck. There wouldn't be anything in the back to look at anyways, unless we put like some speakers back there. So glued mine shut just for ease of painting and working on it. The cab itself, you saw me fiddling with the sunroof. I wanted to open this one up, so I just scribe out that opening using a knife around and around and around, and then I go from the top and saw it out with my X-Acto knife. Then I use the files and evened it out as much as I felt like evening it out. We can take our sunroof glass, put it in from the bottom. It's got a really big lip on it, so gluing it in shall be quite easy. And there we go. We've got a cool sunroof in our sport truck that wasn't there before, and it wasn't hard to do. If you didn't have that groove in the roof, all you'd have to do is mark the inner line on this part here, and then just do the same scribing. You just have to be much more careful since the line isn't molded in place. You could have your own sunroof, and you could cover that with a piece of clear plastic. Got our firewall glued on. The firewall is best glued on to the cab at this point, so that, as you saw when I built it, I could line up the inner fenders and we can make sure that everything lines up. The cab has two secure locking pins. They go right there in the frame, and we can make sure that our fenders line up and everything is a beautiful assembly. Now we can take our chassis with our drive line and our springs and our second drive shaft and our box mount, inner fenders, suspension arms, kingpin, steering rod, and that all glues in place to this sway bar up here. And we are ready to go. We got the springs in there and everything. We can paint that up in one unit. And that's what I'm going to do at this point is, after this nice assembly, everything went together well, I'm going to head on over to paint. as I prepare to close out the build on the Super Stones, the 1978 Ford Courier from AMT. Let's take a look at where we are, all the detail that I've put into it, and then all I need to do is finish the final assemblies with some super glue to hold stuff together. Then we will place my chosen decals on there. We got some cool windshield banners, we got the flames, we got that big white Firestone logo, the hot rod logos, we got the Ford logos for the taillight, we got the Firestone logos for the fenders, and the Courier and XLT logos. If you just want to build a nice step side Ford Courier, you've got that option on here, and you can do it with the stockish wheels. So, got our cab together. You can see how I masked that off. I didn't do it in a bright white. I did it in the insignia white so that it wouldn't be so glaring, and I do like it. And it's kind of like an off-white like they had on the box art. So I do like that. I've got my fender flares here. When the vehicle is all placed together, those fender flares will then line up round about there, just so we get that continuous white all the way around, and then the little stripe that will go in, and it will follow itself all the way around there, and that's how that's going to work. So we've got that all together. I've got the sunroof glued in, I've got the glass glued in, I've got the trim. I left everything around here in a red, just like the box art. I like it like that. If I was custom painting one, I would get rid of all the silver and the metallic on there and just have it going around. We got our back glass. I use the more bulgy custom glass instead of the flat window. When you do use the sunroof, you have to cut the windshield free from that piece of glass that we showed during the parts review. That's more than easy enough to do with just some snippers. And now we've got our cab ready to go. The grill is done. I placed some gloss Mod Podge in the chrome headlights, and that makes them look much more like glass. Black washed in there. Our front bumper will mount to these little points here. Once we get all of that attached, our hood will sit nicely across there. It's got those louvers in it. That's going to look sweet. What else we got going on? We got our radiator hose I have to mount just before we're done. I've got the front and rear bumpers that need to go on, and the chrome side steps for the step side bed that will need to go on once we have everything located. Now we get to the vehicle itself. I've got the tonneau cover on the bed. It's not glued in place, but I'll never be removing it. So during final assemblies, I think I want to put that cool Firestone logo on the bed. Did our little button work, and that will come off there easily. We got our bed with our little metallic gas cap. You can do that in red or any color you want. Got our tailgate with our taillights and our little chains to hold that together. We still need to put the Ford logo across the back. Our body, or our interior, is all set up. I put the silver looking CB radio in there to look like a Cobra radio and black washed it. Got our sports steering wheel, got our dashboard, got our seats. I brushed on some gloss coat across the dashboard and the steering wheel, and you saw me spray the seat. Did our door panel up with the silver marker, and we have our nice basic black interior. Since this frame is completely open at the bottom, I did give it a little bit of spritz of red on the bottom to blend in. Then we've got our red radiator mount, our black inner fenders. That's how I chose to do it, with a little bit of red firewall overspray on there. We've got our four-cylinder engine mounted into its two drive shafts. We've got our reservoir tank, our battery, our radiator. That looks pretty nice in there. And then underneath, we're going to have our exhaust with the heat shield, our fuel tank, and these absolutely hot-looking turbine-style wheels with the Firestone Super Sports tires on them. That is a badass-looking tire and wheel combo for this truck or any vehicle. You get that black wash in there over the matte spray. Those look tough as nails. So we're going to get everything together, get the decals on it. We're going to brush on two coats of clear coat. I'll be back for the final. Going to do a little bonus segment on this video. I'm also going to send this out as its own video, but those of you that are cool enough to watch these videos from beginning to end, you will get this extra little bonus content before I produce it into another video. As a lot of us know out there, the product Pledge Revive It or Future Floor Polish, that I love to use, that I've been using for years and years and years and years, is said by some to be completely discontinued. Some say there's an industrial version available. Some say you can still buy it, but you have to buy it in a gallon bottle. I don't know either way. Some claim to have gotten emails from SC Johnson. Some claim that that email is not correct, that that employee is mistaken. I really don't care. I have a bottle this size, lasts me years. I build two model kits per year, or two model kits per week. This lasts me multiple years. Well, I have a couple bottles of this, so I should be set literally for about 6 or 7 years. But for those of you who aren't able to source this, and a lot of you can still source this, you know where I found my last couple bottles at? Fleet Farm, for $4 a bottle, standard price. Menards or Walmart usually carried this for about $6.50. I found it at Fleet Farm. They still had a whole bunch on the shelves there. So they're still going through old stock. Maybe you could get some from there. But anyways, that's where I get it. It's a beautiful product. Does excellent on glass, clear windows. We know how Pledge works. I've shown it in so many videos how I apply it. I apply it simply with a brush. Well, strolling through the aisles in Walmart, I came across this product on the shelf in almost the same spot that Pledge used to be, called Quick Shine Multi-Surface Floor Finish. This is the bottle. Feel free to pause the video. They sell it in this size, which is 27 ounces for like, it was under $5 when I got it about a month ago by Holloway House since 1962. It's got this kind of sprayer just like Pledge. And it is supposed to be a clear gloss, non-violent, non-volatile floor shine. It says directions, just like future floor polish. Apply directly onto a clean, dry floor. Spread evenly with a mop or sponge. Dries to a gloss in 45 to 60 minutes. That's exactly the instructions you get on the back of the bottle of Pledge. Contains filtered water, zinc-free polymer, polymer emulsions, plasticizer, mild solvent, leveling surfactant, preservative, anti-foam. For more information, visit their website. So it says it's a safer choice, meets EPA safer product standards. So I'm going to apply this. If I want it to be a substitute for Pledge, then I'm going to use it the exact same way. The way I apply Pledge is, I screw the top off the bottle, I dip my fuzzy brush in it, and I literally just liberally wipe it over the entire model, glass and all. So I'm going to do this. I've already shaken it up. Pledge you never need to shake up, crystal clear. This I can't see inside the bottle, and I'm not pouring the whole bottle out to see if there's stuff at the bottom, but it always makes sense. It doesn't hurt anything. Give it a good shake. I've already shaken this one up. I'm going to take the top off. We're going to go through the process of brushing it on the model. Then we're going to let it dry. We're going to come back. We're going to see. So when I get back, we're going to be brushing it on the model. Okay, so let's open up the Quick Shine bottle. Top comes off. We'll give it a... has no odor at all, actually. Well, maybe it kind of smells like a crayon, like a wax, you know? It is, it's not perfectly clear. It's a very, very, very diluted white. And now Pledge, we know when we put Pledge on a model that it also turns a milky white as it dries. It turns quite white. Sometimes it'll scare you a little bit. So that's completely normal for a clear to be somewhat white. So let's get it out. Put it on the hood first. I always do, oh yeah, it's definitely a milky white. I always do this over a towel so that it soaks up the edges. Okay, so we can see that it's definitely a milky white texture. So it's kind of like future after it's been allowed to dry for a few minutes. And now when I apply future, I brush it on to make sure everything's coated. And then I walk away and I brush it on quite thick. But now this, I'm not going to touch that again. Now this is going over fresh decals that have been allowed to dry, because that's how I apply Pledge. It's never messed with my decals. So if I want to use it as a replacement, it has to work the same. Chris, do you ever airbrush future floor polish? I certainly have. When I built the engine, the aircraft turbine from Atlantis a couple of years ago, that is such a delicate and complex structure with pipes and wires everywhere that I airbrushed that, and I think I even airbrushed it on camera. But this is how I apply it to every model that I use it. And I go right over the glass, as you saw, and I'll apply it a couple times to some areas to bring the shine up. And we apply it to everything. We don't shy away. I try not to get it on the tires because I don't like tires that shiny. And you see I'm going right over the glass and the decals. I can tell you that when applying it, it's very shiny because it's wet. But let's just see what happens. I apply it over chrome. I apply Pledge over chrome, so that's what I'll be doing here. And I do it all once. When I say two coats in the videos, what I mean is that I apply it on, and then I go and apply it again before it's completely dry. I never mess with it after I've left it to dry. Though, future floor polish is so forgiving, you can let it completely dry, and then you can apply another coat later after it's dried. It doesn't care at all. But we're not going to test that theory yet. We'll get to that in due time in another video another day. But I just make sure the entire model is kind of saturated, top and bottom, side to side. Future has never reacted with a decal. It's never reacted with any paints or inks or anything. So, and that's what I expect from this product if I'm going to say, sure, go ahead and give it a shot. So now we'll go around. The hood's got quite a bit, so we're not going to do the hood again. But we'll go ahead and do the painted surfaces. I usually only do the glass once, but we'll do the chrome and the painted surfaces. We'll get a good amount on there. It's self-leveling, so if you just leave it alone, floor polishes will level themselves out. Don't keep, oh, I need to adjust that and all that stuff. Don't do that. You're just going to screw it up. So there we go. The second coat goes on super duper quick. This is a little more, Pledge seems a little thicker when I apply it. This is extremely water thin liquid. In fact, it might have a little water wetter, like a, it doesn't have glycerin, but there's chemicals that they use to make water, to make things flow even smoother than just plain water. But it also breaks up the surface tension. So now we've got our two coats on everything. And what I'm going to do is, it says 45 to 60 minutes to let it dry. I don't wait for that long. I place mine in a food dehydrator for about 30 minutes at 90 degrees, no hotter, just 90 degrees in a food dehydrator, and that dries it off in 30 minutes or less, usually about 15, 20 minutes, and I notice it's done. So that's what I'm going to do with this. You know, just a few minutes in that food dehydrator, and then we will come back and see if it's a shiny surface, see if it ruined my decals, see what it did. Okay, so it's been an hour, half an hour at 90 degrees in the dehydrator, and then another half an hour just kind of sitting outside, cooling down and everything so I could touch it. It is dry on the surfaces. I can touch it. It doesn't seem to hold a fingerprint. It's got a nice shine to it. Doesn't have like any big defects or anything. Now keep in mind, when I make my models, I spray the color. I don't sand, I don't wet sand, I don't buff, I don't polish. I spray and pray, and that's how it is. So when I apply the clear coat over it, that's how it's gonna lay. And the quick shine does a really nice job. I mean, not noticing any issues on the glass. You can see that shine going across the roof. The glass is crystal clear. The sunroof, the forward glass, the back glass. The chrome is still shiny. I do notice in the crevice here, I did put it on super thick, that it is still a little cloudy. Probably take a few hours for that to go away. On the side steps, the chrome is clear. The white is glossy. The red's glossy. Over the decals, let's see if we can get it. Oh, sure. Yeah, there's the gloss over the decals. So over the decals, it glossed it up. We got the chrome grill in the front and the red. Chrome is still shiny. The grill's still shiny. The two-tone looks good. Yeah, so my initial test, I'm not going to vouch for this lasting a million years. I'm not going to vouch for it not turning yellow in 10 years. I have noticed the whiners that say that, not whiners, sometimes it comes across that way. The people who have had a different experience over my literal thousands of experiences with Future Floor Polish or Pledge Revive It, a very small number of those people, not whiners, just a small number, have claimed that Pledge turns yellow after a decade of sitting in a house. One thing I've noticed is when those people complain on Facebook, I look at their profiles, almost all of them have been shown to be heavy smokers or bad housekeepers. People that allowed thick dust, smoke in their house to turn white paint with Future Floor Polish over it yellow. Maybe that has something to do with it. I don't know. I have slathered this stuff on 600 models now, and even more pieces of clear plastic that I would do that even if I wasn't using it on the model, I would put it in. I have friends that modeled back in the day, and they knew I had this stuff. They do a lot of jets. They would hand me entire trees for their models that I could dip them, and then they'd put them back in the box and put them back in their stash so that years from now when they went to do the glass, it wasn't all scratched up and scuffed up. Not one of those people have said that that turned yellow. Fine Scale Modeler magazine and Scale Auto and all the other magazines have been recommending this for glass for 20, 25, maybe even 30 years, back in the original Pledge bottles. None of those people have said it's ever turned anything yellow on their prize show winning canopies for aircraft. And I'm sure if it was, they'd say something. So on the future, I know it doesn't. On the quick shine, we don't know. I've never really looked at it before. I've never used it before. It definitely is a good substitute for Pledge now that this is not available. You can see it does a great job. I mean, the model looks awesome. So I'm going to recommend it, a preliminary recommend. I'm going to leave this model out. I normally store all my models away in boxes on top of each other. This one I will leave out for the next year. We'll revisit it. I will be using this, but now I know for you that are looking for one, hey, heck, I'm going to go out and make a quick recommendation and say, give it a shot, see what happens. It's inexpensive. Try it out. See what you think about it. I definitely like it. I'm going to recommend it and say, as far as I can tell so far, we got a beautiful shine with no crackle, no problems, no nothing. Dries quickly, looks nice and glossy, and goes on easy. It's a thumbs up from Chris at HPI Guys Workshop. Well, here we go. We have completed the Firestone Super Stones 1978 Ford Courier mini truck. It's a total customized step side mini truck, four banger powered from Ford, done up for Hot Rod magazine. It is a cool little machine. If you stuck around and watched the entire video, you saw me test out a new floor-based polish clean, a gloss coat that I put on the model. So make sure to go back in the video and check that out if you just skip to the very end. What a nice looking little truck. It looks tough. I like how things are modular. The model was a little challenging for the final assemblies. The cab didn't want to sit right at first. I ended up going to the back of the cab and slicing off the very top of the interior about 1/8 of an inch off the top of the interior with my nippers. I just snipped right across, and then I got the cab to sit much more level. I don't know. It must have been an assembly issue on my end. I did not need to do that with the other Courier. So somewhere along the line, I made a boo-boo. And I fixed it, and I didn't have a problem with anything else. Looks awesome. We got the nose on there. We got the little fender flares glued on separately. We got the cool custom grill. Cut in the sunroof on this one. The decals laid down beautifully. The red does not match my cherry red my red pepper exactly. You can see the difference. This was a hard color to match. I wasn't sure what to use. And the manual just says red, rouge. So it was difficult to pick out which red they wanted me to use. Probably a tester's red or something that I don't use. But the Krylon match is good enough. It looks awesome. I love the decals on here. The big Firestone laid down. The fenders. Everything. The doors. The windshield banner looks flipping sweet. So yeah. Excellent model. Fun to put together. These wheels with those tires are so hot. Those would look awesome on so many vehicles. Just everything is cool. The little chrome side steps, the special tail lights, the little bed chains, the Ford emblem, the tonneau cover, that bubble window, the custom window in the back. I just really enjoyed this kit. So I'm going to link in the description where you can snag this little custom mini truck for yourself at autoworldstore.com. As always, thanks for watching the workshop. This is Chris. I want you to build your models for you. I think some of you should pick this up and do it as a total custom paint job and have nothing to do with the Superstones thing, and do it your own way and show me on the Facebook page, HPI Guys Workshop on Facebook. We will see all of you at the next review.